parents didn't listen to you again said, damn, she killed it. We're gonna try to sum it up and see what we can extract as far as the personal style and signature looks. It's right there, right now. Hello people, welcome back to my channel. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bon retour sur ma chaîne. Hola, bienvenue de la ami canal. Konnichiwa, watashi no channel ni yokoso. We're gonna have another episode of Decoding Style. Without going any further, I'm having a cold. It's been there for days and days. It's okay. I'm here, I'm motivated. She's gorgeous. She is amazingly stylish, but even more so, she was bisexual, she discovered that she was pansexual, and all that sexuality that she didn't necessarily talk about a lot at the beginning, becoming that story she wants to share to the world. It's not that signature look, what we can learn from that, come up with our own signature look based on our own story. Subscribe to the channel because you're gonna have a lot more. If you didn't know who I am, I'm Jannelle Monae, I'm a personal style coach, and I'm so passionate about helping creative women entrepreneurs uncover the personal style so they can show up being confident in the lives and the businesses. I'm definitely a Hello Kitty obsessed too. To understand her personal style, you have to go deep back. Jannelle Monae comes from a highly religious family, which was Baptist. Because of that, she wasn't able to express her sexuality at that point. She wouldn't necessarily talk much about her sexuality even up until today, where she is a little bit more open to it. Hear all those voices and questioning the Bible, and whatever you feel is the right feeling you're supposed to have, all based on all those stories that you hear for years and years and years. I'm talking about the sexuality because it was a big part of her story. Early on, she went and embodied and created that persona. Cindy May Waiter was a revolutionary robot who fell in love with a human. And that android was devoted to free the rest of androids. So she literally created a story based on her own, I would say, fears, because she didn't want to say it out loud. Created the whole visual around that. We get to the personal style now, because for all those years that she was embodied that cinema waiter, that character persona that we knew for years and years and years, had that androgynous look about her. The suits, the blazers, the black and white theme, that again here is another symbol, another meaning to her life. It was much more emotional because black and white for her represented a uniform based on her parents, because she was coming from a working class family. Her mother was a janitor, her dad was a truck driver, and they all used to wear uniforms. So it was a way for her to pay them homage, homage, like we can say in French. Feel thankful, feel grateful for all the experiences, all that education and all those good things that she learned from them. Your real personal style, your true personal style is gonna be based on your own stories, based on your own experiences. That's how you want to show yourself to the world. That's why you want to showcase the most about your story, about your experience, about yourself as a person to the world. So now we're getting to why it was so androgynous. Masculine, there was a lot of that all in one. Coming in the music industry, all she saw was people that were supposed to look a certain way, her included. She didn't feel like she was thinking like a lot of people around her, because when you listen to her music up until today, there's a lot of fusion here. There's the soul, there's the hip-hop, there's the funk, there's electronic music. There's so much when it comes to mixing all those genres, and that would say a lot about her as a person and the way she was seeing the world. Again, personal style here. Because she felt that way, everything that she was wearing was a way to not conform to the way that people were seeing black female artists back in the day and even now. And that's how she stood out up until dirty computers. Not being open about her sexuality, she was battling depression because she was going in therapy for years, and all she was thinking is that she had computer virus. I use her own words. And like she was sick, there was something wrong with her. I felt like I was not belonging to a group. I felt like I was so different because I was thinking a certain way. I was seeing the world a certain way. And I feel a lot happier with my life. But back then, just like Jannelle Monae, I had that feeling where dressing up a certain way, people would eye on me. in a good and a bad way. People would admire that, or people would be like, you weird. You know what I mean? The way I was dressing up reflected the way I was being inside. But at the same time, I was hiding myself because I would do it. But at the same time, I was like, I want to belong to a group. But if I do it, I kind of not being myself. I have to put a mask. And that's what she did for years. Her way of creating that character, Cindy Mayweather, was just because she was scared of being judged. Everything inside her sexuality was a reason for her to have to create that world. On top of that, being perfectionist, being an overthinker, just like I am, she was being really, really focused on details. And that's what I love about her visuals, when it comes to the video clips, when it comes to the way she presents herself to the world, how she managed to create that signature style with the suits and all the blazers. Yes, it's a part of her, but back then, when she was battling through all of those emotions and ideas and expectations from anybody else around her, it was literally picturing all of that. Battling through all of those opposite emotions, opposite feelings, and being perfectionist and being overthinker led her to create that mask, led her to protect herself. She used Cindy Mayweather as a way to protect herself. Now getting to Dirty Computers, the album. So the whole story around this album is a masterpiece. I watched it, I was amazed. She's still having a signature look, but in a lot more feminine way and a little bit more liberated, because you can see that, you can feel that from her. In Dirty Computers, you can see, it's amazing, nothing to say. Something a little bit more sexy about her, but it's still her. She still made it an art. She still made it an art of expressing yourself. Mission was for her to be, you can be free on your sexuality. Be okay with that, be open with that, be liberated. And going from her thinking that she had a virus and there was something wrong about her, and now getting to the Dirty Computers and be like, you know what? I'm gonna take care of you. You're a dirty computer, I'm a dirty computer myself, and I own it. I own it because it's me, because it's a part of me. And you can see it, open about saying that she was in woman relationships, man relationships, she's a bisexual, now she's pansexual, more so being attracted to you as a person before being a man or a woman. Being free to love whoever you want without having to feel that pressure, and more so her being a black female artist in the music industry. You being black, you being a woman, you being pansexual or not necessarily in the norms is totally fine. We talked a lot about Jannelle Monae evolution and her personal style along with it. Now we're gonna get to the signature look. A signature look has to start with your emotion. Creating a signature look doesn't start with you looking up on Pinterest and trying to inspire yourself from whoever you admire the most. It starts with you. That is here inside your emotions, your triggers. That's gonna be the core of your signature look and the stories you want to show to the world, because we all have different stories. It's up to you to choose which one you want to show to the world. The thing that is gonna bring you even more confidence by doing so. Wanting to feel confident, building that confidence up, and being able to message that to the world in your own creative ways. It's whatever people can picture you wearing whenever they think about you. If you were to be a character, a fairy tale persona, what is the reason to actually have a signature look? Everybody is not gonna care about having a signature look, right? Everybody is not gonna care about having to think about creating one, right? So it's okay. When it comes to you, if you're following on this channel, you already know that when it comes to helping creative women entrepreneurs, it's all about being authentic for me. When we think about Jannelle Monae, we think about something specific. We can think about the black and white theme, we can think about the androgynous part of her. Instead of having a complete mismatch of a couple of pieces, having a signature look refines all of that, defines all of that, and defines your personal style even more. The number two reason here is because it takes a lot to get to know yourself at that level. And being able to not only know yourself, know your values, know what you stand for, and create a way to visually show it, to visually message it to the world, it takes incredible confidence. It's not about the clothes, it's about how you see yourself. Signature look for me, it's the personal style to its finest. Not because it's trendy, it's not because it's fashionable. In a way, you don't need to know your personal style 100% when it comes to creating your own signature look. An everyday process, the act of building that signature look, amplify all of that. Because you're gonna learn so much more about yourself. You're gonna be excited through the journey and much less about the destination. Because personal style is all about the journey. Make your journey exciting and fun. Not knowing what to wear and then trying to wear something, loving it, hating it, and then maybe in the middle of that, discovering something new about yourself. Maybe something that you really definitely don't like at all. Because you can't predict that. It's gonna be the core elements of your style. It's gonna be the core pieces of your style. Even better, a signature look is gonna help you to get away from those I don't know what to wear in the morning. Let me explain. Most women tend to wear 20% of a closet 80% of time. So when it comes to knowing your signature looks, you're gonna be able to optimize out of that and get those 20% 100% right. You're gonna be able to optimize your wardrobe and being able to focus on those core elements and be able to go from there to build up a versatile system. Instead of trying to add up anything without having a strategy, you have a focus, you have a point. Everything you're gonna do is to build up everything around that. Magic behind a signature look. I'm telling you. Think to a couple of misconceptions we have about signature looks, because the couple, obviously. Be convinced that your signature look has to be bold, has to be statement-ish, which is totally, but totally false. I took Jannelle Monae here as an example because she is really close to my own personal style. I love her for that because it's bold, but you have other style icons like Charlotte Gainsbourg, more in the minimalistic. Anna Wintour is another one, really feminine, and she nice little pretty dress. Current moment, your current now, how is it? Focus on the current and then plan from there. It's up to you to choose how you want to define your signature look. Do you want to be more specific around the items you're gonna have on you and have a little variation around them? That's gonna be somebody like Charlotte Gainsbourg. Or what you want to do is to have a more loose formula where you have more different items and then you have a lot more variety when it comes to it. That could be Jannelle Monae, wherever you find yourself being, or you can be somebody in the middle. And that's something that I'm gonna teach on my one-on-one coaching, starting up soon, so get ready for it. Where you define yourself is gonna be the story for everything else when it comes to defining your personal style. When it comes to a signature look, you need to think about the core essence of your style along with your lifestyle. Because at the end of the day, the point here and the purpose here and the goal here is to build up a functional wardrobe. Not the point for you to create a wardrobe based on your dream life. We're getting to the reality here. You need to think about being pragmatic here, starting by defining your personal style. So what are the core elements? Your color palette, the proportions, the pieces, all of that. Gonna work on that and refine it even more, how you want to see it on yourself. You can love something on somebody and then having it on you, it's something else. Or maybe it's not yet a part of your personal style. Now when it comes to being a little bit more functional, where do you spend the most time at work? Is it at home? Are you somebody who works from home, who goes out a lot? So if you have kids, you need to think about that as well. The heels here could be good, could be great if they're in your dream life, but when it comes to reality, sometimes it just doesn't match. So are they gonna be a part of your signature look? They could be a part of your personal style in general. Hope it was helpful for you. I hope it helped you. Let me know if you're a Jannelle Monae obsessed just like me. What did you learn the most about this and about signature looks in general? In the comment section down below, obviously. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram because there I'm sharing a lot about self-confidence. I'm kind of going back to my source and my roots when it comes to my own personal style. And it's really much more emotional. And I think for this episode, when I got to read a lot more about Jannelle Monae's stories and everything around her own upbringing, around her own background, I realized how hard it was for her to kind of show herself, to read her and the way she was to the world and how she was able to use that persona and make it so big and now being really much more sexually free. Such a different perspective and you're fearing being judged for it. Whatever it's gonna be in front of you, you're gonna be able to tackle it the best way you can. And the signature look is a part of your journey. It's a part of discovering more about your strengths, your weaknesses. I can't wait for you to let me know what you liked about it the most because Yes, for the time being, of course, subscribe to the channel, hit on the bell notification button. Of course, I'm gonna see you for my next video. Comme je le dis toujours, le mot de la fin, smile because it's free and contagious. Bye.